This is an idea that's been there for a long time. I think way back in early 2000s, there was a talk of a virtual technical university that could be launched and all that. And then I think NPTEL has been a huge roaring success in terms of reaching out from IIT to many people.
So there was a town hall meeting with all faculty. I remember attending that, and I was very excited to see that IIT is actually being this open-minded about a program which has never been done in the past by any IIT.
There is a big group of interested learners who will benefit from an outreach from an IIT. And it was just a coming together of a critical mass of people with ideas and capabilities and all of that. And as it turns out, that has happened in IIT Madras first.
It's not possible to name a couple of people for this thing. But overall, then director, Master Ramurti, could be one strong force behind this thing. They have been students of this institute themselves, like you see Andrew Thangaraj and others. They have studied here, and their concept of making this type of education available to everybody and anywhere is the most unique part of this concept.
Just to give it the gist, we started planning for the program in September 2019, so which was pre-COVID, and we had no inkling COVID was coming, and so we were planning to launch everything, assuming that, you know, students would be there. How do you give them a campus experience, but with them not being on campus? How do you give them association with each other? How do you get them to interact and so on? So a lot of things went into the planning, because we knew that the nature of the program would be where students would not necessarily, you know, interact with each other physically a lot. And that was the way we started.
And what we have been able to do is we have been able to identify students who have missed out on an opportunity to learn from an institute like IIT.
Hello everyone, mera naam Anshu hai and I'm from Bihar, but I'm working in Hyderabad.
Hi, this is Kritika, I'm from Bangalore.
Chennai lenda vara.
Myself Kalpana, I'm from Chennai.
I've come from Abu Dhabi.
I'm Aditi from Bangalore.
Saurabh Singh from Motihari, Bihar.
My name is Gautam Gala and I'm from Bombay.
Everyone, I'm Abhishek from Nalanda, Bihar.
I'm Shubhay Bhomik, I'm from Calcutta.
Purusharan from Vishakhapatnam.
Haryana.
Tamil Nadu, throughout district of Tamil Nadu.
From Jaipur, Rajasthan.
There has always been this thing that the IIT degree is something very exclusive. I mean, people give a lot of importance to the JEE entrance exam. And I think that's not the way it should be. I mean, that doesn't sort of feel right.
As a JEE aspirant, I feel it is a very good opportunity, golden opportunity for the all JEE aspirants who have not able to clear JEE Advanced but have access to the IIT Madras through this vital degree.
At a very local level, right, we realize that very good students in this country are not limited to whom we get to meet in IITM.
See, IIT process is to have a very tough entrance exam and then have a very narrow filter to let people in. So here we were not doing that.
It's a different degree. It gives you a different, it has a different curriculum. Mm-hmm. It has different courses. It has a different goal in life.
We are going to have a large funnel and then slowly filter people who are really hardworking, determined and have the capability to come out with the degrees.
It's more of a pyramid thing than a parallel thing. So I guess, if something is this different from what we do, then you should have a different, separate entrance exam.
Right? I mean, the whole idea of teaching over here is that you reach as many people as possible. And then hopefully, you know, without sort of diluting what you are doing over there, you should still be able to challenge the students as part of the course. And, you know, once they are able to do it, then why not? Right? I think that's sort of been the goal of a lot of the faculty that I've met over the past few years.
I think this thing, obsession we have that, you know, the one exam that you write in your life and the top 20,000 students in that exam are the only people who are going to be great in life. Everybody else is a failure and all that. I think it's that thought has to go.
I think earlier the JEE is kind of a barrier which no one likes. Even those who get through it probably would agree that they would rather have had more fun in their 10th to 12th instead of, you know, spending years and years working on cracking one exam. So I think everyone will agree that we should have a better system in place than the JEE.
So we have a lot of people, so there are almost 16,000 plus people in the program. But what we find to be really interesting and exciting for us is a lot of students who never thought IIT was within their reach, or IITs were not in their plans at all, right? So people who even gave up on math or science in their class 10. So we are finding so many students like that. There are students who have who do not have a formal education after class 12, who are coming into this program and benefiting out of the learning experiences.
You see, there I had two dreams. One is to study in IIT, and second is I wanted to become a data scientist. And I think this particular course is helping me to achieve my dreams. I'm very excited.
IIT, proud to be an IIT.
This has been my dream.
See, I think the IIT brand name has a huge credibility, and this program has been sort of very, very cautious of that and very conscious of that also, and the credibility is maintained.
Right. So a lot of people will come thinking that, you know, it's a, this gives me a stamp of success. I don't have to do anything else beyond that. So that is not a, that group needs more effective filtering. You know, we have to be sure that they're really capable. But as opposed to people who come in with a passion for data science and studying and all that. So that group is much easier to deal with.
Entering into this degree, you don't need any prerequisite. All you have to do is they will provide you content, 4 weeks of content. You don't need any coaching. You don't need anything. Even if you are poorest of the poor person, then also you don't have to go to any tutor and get knowledge. All you have to do is if you have that level of IQ, you will get into an IIT. So,
there is nothing about real IITs. This IIT tag is created by students inside IIT and outside IIT. Okay, IIT tag doesn't mean you are successful in life. Those are different times. I have seen IITians failing in life. I have seen non-IITians doing great in life. So that's a myth. You are studying from IIT, a recognized degree you will be getting. That means you are an IIT. You will be part of IIT.
So I would say reach. We are able to reach a vast majority of students, which we were otherwise missing out. Secondly, the execution, the IT infrastructure and the design of the program and the sessions, right, the live sessions, I would say, where interactions happen. Doing all that and keeping the rigor intact, I think those are the success factors. Amazingly done.
So, life, being successful in life needs a very well-rounded personality with a lot of other characteristics, and I don't think the one single exam for which, you know, you spend lakhs of rupees coaching up people and, you know, going and writing. I mean, it does define. I'm not belittling the students of the Vedic program by any chance. There are some very good students there. That is also true. I mean, it's okay. But I don't think that shuts the door for anybody else.
Thank you.
realize that if students are spread out across the country, how do they reach us? How do they get in contact with us? It's not like they can physically walk into our office and then get their issues resolved. And how many phone calls and how many, you know, emails can we answer?
You have to pay attention to students, attention to courses, attention to faculty. There's so many small issues that you have to pay attention to.
I think it's actually the drive of the team over here. Right? I mean, they're all very positive and they have a fairly clear idea of why they want to do it.
Everybody here, one thing you would see is every staff involved is passionate about what they are doing. They are doing it with an understanding of the social impact that they are creating through these activities.
And so the team knows a lot about how to run an online program on a massive scale. Right? And given that background, I think we at least had that confidence that yes, there is a good chance of this happening.
College, but I don't think that at this point online courses are helping anyone much.
Okay. I think online education has helped me because we can choose like our teachers. अगर आपको एक teacher पसंद नहीं आया तो आप दूसरे किसी channel YouTube courses, there are so many courses.
If we do it with self-discipline, like we can make it through.
Main thing we lack is. See, going to school is not just only about studying what's in the book, okay? It's more of a discipline thing.
Mm-hmm.
You learn the discipline over there. You get up early in the morning, you have to be in the school at a certain time. So when you are doing the online thing, you miss that out, you know?
Online education, we don't have to travel. We can relax
in the near future might, you know, replace this traditional course of action and education.
You are just being... Yeah, you are not being educated, you are just being certified.
In a offline class, which is the regular mode of interaction on campus, student has an option of asking a question there and then.
From there, of course, I had to make a little bit of a transition to teaching in a room like this, where you don't have interaction with any student and you are just talking to a camera essentially.
Well, I don't think that is a major hurdle.
I managed to get two young fellows to sit in my course. They used to sit here in this very room and they used to ask me questions, and you know, that kind of made, I think, the course a little bit better, I think.
From my perspective, there is no interaction, and that's beautiful, because just think about it. It's like I started something and occasionally I'm nudging it and it's proving to something brilliant. That's fantastic. That is return on effort.
So there are differences, but well, in the offline class, if you are stuck somewhere and you want to hear that concept being taught in the classroom again, you don't have a choice. Here you have a choice. You can always go back to the video and watch it again.
So I am Dipanjan Raut. I am a student of the BS in Data Science and Application from IIT Madras. And besides this, I am working on my startup projects and I am working on different hackathon projects and ideas.
The parts which we use for every hackathon. So today we basically have a meet, where we intend to create some part of our future project. So these things are part of our daily life, we say. You can see some strange things lined up, but yeah, these are hardcore realities.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, Shashwat.
Hi, Ronak.
Ito record hocchi.
Hocchis ta ki?
This guy.
কি নিয়ে
কাজ করছো তোমরা?
সোলারের উপর একটা প্রজেক্ট করছি। অ্যাকচুয়ালি দে আর ওয়ার্কিং অন মাল্টিপল প্রজেক্টস, ওটা একটা ব্যাপার। ওটা এটা ফর স্টার্ট আপ, হ্যাঁ। বাকি আছে হ্যাকাথনস এর জন্য আলাদা আছে, ইউ নেভার নো হোয়েন আ হ্যাকাথন টার্নস ইনটু আ স্টার্ট আপ।
No, if you are a student of IIT Madras BS degree, it gives you a lot of opportunities.
Bolo aap, aadha ghanta baad? Thik hai, aadha ghanta baad? Haan, thik hai.
Kar lete hain aadha ghanta baad.
So if you keep on participating in these kind of competitions, you get to learn a lot of new things. And that's how you will become successful one day.
Aapka to ek khushkhabri bhi hai, jo... आपका थोड़ा कंपनी का डिटेल्स वगैरह दीजिए, अबू धाबी से आपके लिए कुछ अच्छे ऑफर्स आने वाले हैं सुएज ट्रीटमेंट को लेके, तो आपके फाइल, हाँ हाँ, ये तो आपके लिए कुछ, वही बोला ना कल खुशखबरी देंगे।
व्हाट आई फील समथिंग नेगेटिव अबाउट आवर डिग्री, मे बी एवरी वन इज नॉट एबल टू एक्सपीरियंस दैट फ्रेंडशिप और कनेक्ट विद द मासेस. Like the students who are doing the offline degree, who are continuing with their offline degree, they are not able to interact and they don't even get the time to interact and make new friends over here. But IIT Madras BS degree is not merely this thing, it is much more than that. And to experience that, you need to, you know, participate in events. Make some connections, meet some good friends, and you never know when you meet them offline. The friendship deepens and you feel the real bond, which you might not experience online.
I'll actually tell you when I really felt this program was really is doing what it is doing. That was when I attended Paradox last time.
So one of the things we wanted and we were getting asked by students is, can we come to the campus? Can we come to the campus?
It was just a fun conversation where we said, we being an online degree, we are all going to have a fest offline. So that itself is a paradox. How can this happen?
We thought, why not try to do something where it is a lean period for the on-campus program and we can kind of manage them to be here for 2-3 days, which should provide better interaction amongst the various sections of students and also help showcase their ability.
When it actually happened, we could see that there were 2000 plus students on campus and all of them were so enthusiastic.
And the other excitement for us was there was a small section of students who had completed one diploma. So it was like an achievement for us too, because we had crossed like one major milestone in the program.
What really came out was everybody in that group had chosen to do this program, which is unlike most college degrees. Most college degrees people choose because that's what they get based on their marks or based on their rank in an exam or something. Here that was not the case. Everybody had voluntarily chosen to do this, so that passion was emanating everywhere, and that really was an exciting thing to see.
Anyways, so the next performance I would like to call upon Utkarsh for a Latin dance.
This is Yuhi or Utkarsh, and I am a student at IIT Madras, and I'm 23 years old. I use they, them pronouns, which
which can get a little bit hard to navigate, and probably, as we figured out by now, not anywhere on the straight spectrum of things.
Okay, so yeah, I think that was like the most surprising thing. Andrew sort of like knowing me by name, I was just like, am I a celebrity? And turns out I kind of was, because I mean, I was wearing these earrings, so I was definitely standing out, true to my, you know, mission of standing out.
So, as of now, the program is very diverse.
The thing that really stuck out to me was like, whenever I think I've ever had an encounter with an educational authoritative person, like basically a person who's an education, like educator, also in a position of authority, I have always sort of gotten invasive questions from them.
I think as we are getting more and more exposure with different types of people, we are accepting them more.
Because once a person is in like this position of authority, they think like they can literally ask you anything and it will be completely fine, or it's not uncomfortable at all.
I have personally not noticed anyone treating anyone else differently.
And because I have gotten those invasive questions, I was expecting them. So I had like this, you know, like just ready, like journal in my head. Okay, if they ask this, I have to reply this. If they ask this, and I literally just had to throw that journal in the trash later on because no one asked any invasive questions.
I feel like that's a really great thing. It's not normally seen, and it's different, but it's really nice.
I do have ideas that I want to work on.
I actually asked, you know, how do we deal with inequities relating to getting data from the LGBT community?
Like, for example, I want to collect raw data about our community from all around India and see if there are conclusions that I can derive.
Most of us are closeted, or they don't want to actually actively participate in, you know, any sort of like forums or any sort of forms. Even I don't want to, like, you know, have some random third party company who's just compiling data have data about my sexuality, my gender, such personal information. I don't want to give that away.
There are places where schools are very homophobic. Do they have sensitization about this topic? Like,
so how do we actually go about, you know, including them as part of the data study, as well as maintaining that information as anonymous as possible? Like, we cannot track those people because the people who are handling the data, we don't know their intentions.
Can I assemble a group of people and send them over to schools to, you know, so that we can educate the people, make the people aware about our identity, about who we are?
I like the fact that everyone is forward thinking over here and that everyone's really accepting. I have met a lot of senior citizens who are part of this degree.
So I'm very proud and honored to be feeling and having and possessing the identity of being an IITian.
I have met people from the LGBTQ community. I have not had a chance to meet someone from the EWD community, but I have always found that there is no way of treating them in any different manner. It's all been the same. I'm really happy to see.
Is there scope for more diversity? I would say yes. There is definitely scope for more diversity because we would like more women in the program.
I am Anjali Kataria. I am about to complete my training for the post of Deputy Superintendent of Police in UP. I am also pursuing this degree in Data Science and Programming from IIT Madras.
So currently about 25-30% of the learners are female.
Being a police woman, being a part of this police service, I think that this is going to help me, enable me to get us some skill set in the field of cyber security and cyber forensics, which I am planning to pick later on, and I am learning new skill sets in this direction.
So we would like for that to become 50%.
I think that women should join police service and armed forces, other forces like Navy, Air Force, Army, in large numbers. In at least they are not being represented. Their representation is very low in police or other armed forces. I think I will get a chance to serve in a gender neutral way if I as I am about to join field training in police service. So this is one motivation why I wanted to join it.
Similarly, representation from rural India, if that can improve, that is another thing which we would really like. And people from government school background, so that is another thing which we would like. We would want at least 10% of our student population to be coming from government schools. So these are all targets which we want to achieve, and we keep working towards these diversity goals every day.
I'm not sure there is any such thing as the peak of the diversity. I mean, at the end of the day, that would probably involve, you know, I mean, spreading much beyond India and going outside as well.
Hi, my name is Mishal Abdulaziz, and right now I'm working as a warranty administrator in Hyundai Bahrain. I was born in Bahrain and did most of my schooling over here. Yeah. How do I manage the course with the job? It's something that somehow I'm doing. I was really surprised to be able to meet so many new students. People from diverse backgrounds, different age groups. There are people who are as old as my father and as young as my brother, sitting and writing the exam next to me.
But I think the fact that there is diversity is very clear, and I think that's something we are very happy about, right? That's fundamentally one of the things that we would like to see, right? We don't want it to be sort of exclusive in some way that it makes it difficult for others to join. So, yeah, has it reached the peak of its diversity? I don't know. I don't even know what that exactly means. But I'm glad that it is showing diversity. So.
Hi, Dipanjan and your friends. Hello, hello to.
Hi.
My name. And I am batchmate of Dipanjan Bhai at IIT Madras.
Dekho, ye hota introduction.
I am Ronak. And I'm also in this degree, but batchmate तो नहीं बोल सकते, मेरे foundation में होती है।
तो सीधा सीधा बात ये कि ordinos से अभी एक proper PCB board में migrate करना है हमको।
वहाँ लेकिन हमारे cloud पे data चलाते हैं। जो main problem है और जो आपको solve करना है, वो है ये वाला, जो sensor या फिर जो hardware है, वहाँ से data microcontroller तक कैसा है?
तो हमारा scene क्या है ना, हमारा microcontroller और जो अलग other components है वो एक ही मॉड्यूल में रहेगा, तो हमारा वो नहीं है। आप लोगों का जैसा सेंसर दूसरे जगह रहता है, कंट्रोलर दूसरे जगह रहता है, हमारा वो नहीं है, हमारा साथ में है, तो वो दिक्कत नहीं है हमें।
हमें
दिक्कत हाँ, एक तो पीसीबी डिजाइन करवाना है, एक वो हो गया, और दूसरा ये है कि जो कंट्रोलर हमारा बन रहा है उससे डेटा हम सर्वर पे कैसे डालें।
बेसिकली ही इज राइट, unless we are completely
sure about the prototype, yeah,
we should not go for,
because we should be confident that 500 piece bikna bhi chahiye.
Not that, we should make sure what we are imagining that is connecting to reality.
I'm 30 year old, मैं 30 साल का हूँ।
हाँ।
और मैं दिल्ली से ग्रेजुएट हूँ, normal BSc, TCM।
तो ultimately the students are the ones who give us the confirmation that okay, we are doing something right. When we see students who are motivated, who are actually enthusiastic, they are passionate.
उसके अंदर फिर मैं college graduation के बाद में कुछ government job की तैयारी करी, कुछ जगह success नहीं हो पाया, फिर unorganized sector में मैं job करने लगा। अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर में जॉब करने के अधिकतर नुकसान ही होते हैं। देखो, कोई प्रॉपर छुट्टी नहीं होती, छुट्टी होती तो आपके पैसे कटते हैं, तो थोड़ा सा हाँ
मैं सिर्फ 30 कहूँ तो थोड़ा सा ट्रेवल रहा है पास. कोरोना टाइम की बात थी 2019, 2020, 2021. आई लॉस्ट माई जॉब एट दैट टाइम. तो आई वॉज जस्ट सर्चिंग ऑन इंटरनेट, इंस्टाग्राम. आई वॉज जस्ट लर्निंग कोडिंग फ्रॉम यूट्यूब. तो मेरे एक अंकल हैं, मेरे ताऊ जी हैं, उन्होंने मुझे इस बारे में बताया. फिर मैंने यूट्यूब पे देखा, इसको सर्च करा, तो IIT मद्रास का प्रोमो था वहाँ पे. मैंने फिर अप्लाई करा. मुझे लगा कि ठीक है, अगर सब कुछ स्क्रैच से है, एक नई शुरुआत करना काफ़ी मुश्किल होता है. मैं जॉब चेंज करना चाहता था. मैं चाहता था कि मेरी एंट्री कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर में हो, थोड़ा स्किल बेस्ड कुछ जॉब मिले. लेकिन शुरुआत करना कहीं से आसान नहीं था. जब मैंने IIT का करिकुलम देखा, उसका प्रोमो देखा कि आप 12th किसी भी स्ट्रीम से होनी चाहिए. मैं लकीली BSc है मेरा, तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुई. और
এতটা এক্সপেক্ট করিনি যে এত বছর পরে এসে নতুন করে একটা কোর্স নতুন করে জানবো, বা একটা কোর্সের যদি থ্রু দিয়ে নতুন করে এক্সপিরিয়েন্স করবো পড়াশোনার. বিকজ আমাদের একটা মিসকনসেপশন আছে যে বয়স হয়ে গেলে পড়াশোনার এনার্জি চলে যায়, পড়াশোনা করতে চায় না, অন্যদিকে মন চলে যায়, এসব. এটা একদমই ভুল কথা, কিন্তু সেটা যে কতটা ভুল সেটা আমি এখানে এসে বুঝতে পারছি. বিকজ নতুন করে পড়াশোনা শিখতে পারছি.
দিস ইজ আ ভেরি জব ওরিয়েন্টেড প্রোগ্রাম অ্যাট দ্য হার্ট, ইজন্ট ইট? সো for the next decade or so, this area looks really hot, right? Like, and maybe even going forward, who knows?
It was like I was in class 11 or 12, I think, like preparing for my HS or like something like that.
And as the area evolves, we will also evolve, right? If tomorrow some other subjects become very important, we will be adding those subjects to this program.
So it made me start again, start over. And in a good way, all of that in a good way, all of that in an inspirational way.
So our goal is to, train a large number of students in relevant job areas, give them a good college education and get them out and get them into jobs. That's the loop.
We knew, because we had done some kind of a survey in the industry, we knew that there's a need for people with some data science capability, and quite a large need was there. And, today the need is being fulfilled only by a very select set of people who are coming out of. So it was clear that there is a need, and also it was clear that there is a, between a very high end, like a business consulting analyst kind of position, there is a space in the middle, right, for very large numbers of people to get placed.
We have a very active industry interaction cell. We are actively working on placements and internships. A lot of students who have qualified for internships. So we provide the support after they are at certain level in the program. And we have been able to place a lot of people through internships and even for full-time placement.
Placement officer basically kya hota hai? Companies hai, wo aati hai, wo batati hai ki haan ki hum aapke yahan se placement uthane wale hai. तो उसके लिए वो प्री प्लेसमेंट टॉक होती है.
wow.
जिसमें हम लोग के पास में ईमेल आती है, कैलेंडर का लिंक आता है, गूगल मीट का लिंक आता है, हम लोग उसको टाइम पे ज्वाइन करते हैं. तो प्री प्लेसमेंट टॉक में क्या होता है कि जो कंपनी जो आ रही है रिक्रूटमेंट के लिए, उसके HR, जनरली HR होते हैं, मैनेजर होते हैं, वो अपनी कंपनी के बारे में एक शॉर्ट इंट्रो देते हैं. जो जितने भी कैंडिडेट वहाँ पर ज्वाइन करे होते हैं, हम उनसे क्रॉस क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं. उसके बाद में हमें बताते हैं कि कैसे अप्लाई करना है, कहाँ अप्लाई करना है. वो हमें बताते हैं उनको क्या क्राइटेरिया चाहिए, उनकी क्या एक्सपेक्टेशंस हैं, एग्जाम किस टाइप का होगा, इंटरव्यू के क्या राउंड होंगे. वो मतलब एक हमें पूरा रिव्यू दे देते हैं. उसके बाद में ईमेल वगैरह होती है, उनको कॉन्टैक्ट भी कर सकते हैं. तो एक आपका एक मतलब एक रिव्यू होता है, एक नॉलेज होती है.
इट्स द सब्जेक्ट एंड इफ देयर इज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी आई वुड लाइक टू अवेल इट.
दिस इज आवर मेन ब्रेड एंड बटर, एंड सो वी विल कीप अडैप्टिंग विद दैट. आई थिंक I definitely see that happening. We are doing data science application development now. We may have to do one more subject which is very important for the future. We'll keep adding to that. That part will get added. IITM is thinking about a data science department. It's not yet a reality. There is a data science paper in GATE that people are thinking about. So the area itself will evolve to have master's programs and PhDs and all that. It's a very hot area.
For entrepreneurship, we are closely working with ESL of IIT Madras to provide the required support.
Over the next few years, what the graduates of the program do, how they establish themselves out in society, will really be the litmus test for this program. I can say a lot of other things, But this is what matters.
Other degrees like this will be coming. That is a certainty. We will have one more program launched very soon. So, from IIT Madras. I expect more IITs will also offer similar programs.
So, what we are seeing initially is very good signs. When our students go out and work for companies, when they go out and work for our faculty in projects, we are getting very good vibes and positive signals back. There is no doubt about it. But we have to keep sustaining that. Students have to keep sustaining that.
What we would like to achieve is every student who completes class 12 should be aware that this program exists. This kind of an opportunity exists.
We have to have these big success stories like the BTech students have had over the past, and it will take time.
And we want to make sure that every kid who is completing class 12 knows that this is an opportunity available for them to learn from a premier institution like IIT Madras.
It's very difficult to say that, you know, tomorrow it's going to be as good as any other big, very well accomplished program. And that challenge is with us. We are willing to work hard. We are working hard on it. Students also have to work hard to get there.
All along, you must have heard so many, heard and read so many articles in the newspapers, in magazines, in television shows about IIT Madras. You know that IIT Madras is NIRF ranking 1. But what I would like to say is that you are now IIT Madras, and therefore, when we say IIT Madras is NIRF 1, you are NIRF 1. So, and I also would like to say that this is not just a, you know, ideal statement. In all these rankings, the student community is a very important part of any ranking, whether it is US ranking, NIRF ranking, doesn't matter what ranking you see anywhere in the world for any set of institutions, educational institutions. The student community, what they are, how they are here, what they end up doing after they graduate, all of that data is a very important part of coming up with that ranking. So anytime you see an article, anything that praises IIT Madras, anything that criticizes IIT Madras, please remember you are part of it. You represent this institute wherever you go, and any article you read about IIT Madras is about you. And so anything that you do also reflects on the institute. So that's also something that is a responsibility that you carry with you wherever you go. You may visit us for 3 days, but you are part of us forever. Okay? So thank you.
How's the feel to be in campus, and what do you have to say about this BSD?
What the feeling in this campus? What do you say?
Surreal? How are you doing?
Yeah, surreal.
This is surreal.
This atmosphere, like, atmosphere is completely different.
Yeah, the vibe is completely,
the vibe is completely different. You feel okay, you are something.
Yes.
You are student of India's best college.
It's amazing.
to be in the campus of a top technological institute in the country is a brilliant.
It's good. It actually brings back certain memories from my childhood because I grew up in one such campus. So it's a little bit nostalgic.
It feels really good that we can connect, we can come here, we can enjoy the whole campus. So it's very good.
And I also realized that this would be my only opportunity to learn from the country's best college. So.